Good morning, and welcome to the LSU HSC 2015 video series. Today's program is on DxR, Diagnostic Reasoning, in which LSU students will interview and diagnose virtual patients. What better place to do this than the residency of some local L1s? Why don't we go in and take a look? And here we have three L1s that are about to partake in an adventure in DxR.
Let's do this.
So then he goes, the patient exhibited a positive Babinski sign.
What a buffoon.
Yes.
Well, thanks for those 15 MRIs.
Anything for you, Randy.
I need an MRI for my patient's stat. This is literally the only piece of machinery in the hospital that can give me a definitive diagnosis.
Machine's broken, brat.
What are you talking about? I just saw you let someone out of here.
Said. Sorry, brat. Out of order. Good luck getting 3 of 3 required labs, Doogie Howser.
Deuces.
What does that even mean?
MRI machine broke? Deal with it.
Could I get a consult on this CT?
Here we have a transverse contrast enhanced CT image of the pelvis, which reveals low attenuating masses in both the adnexae and in the posterior cul-de-sac. These are associated with indistinct margins of the uterus and ovaries. Septated elliptical structures and the adnexae here are suspicious for dilated fluid-filled fallopian tubes. Bilateral tubal arrhythmia and tubal ovarian abscesses are seen clearly. Perihepatic lesions are also noted. What do you think the diagnosis is?
Bad.
Really?
Yeah, we're gonna go with bad.
Alright, I'm gonna need you to say ah for me now.
What the hell do you think you're doing? You never blade a pediatric patient you suspect of having epiglottitis.
What an incredibly fortuitous event to have such a knowing physician walk by the room at this exact moment.
Yeah,
hey, so you wanted to speak to me?
Yeah. I was wondering why you wanted a referral on a 72-year-old patient who had smoked the equivalent of 150 pack years, who shows literally every sign of COPD. I'll take care of it, buddy.
What brings you here today?
Well, Doc, I don't have an arm.
So, when did you first notice these symptoms?
Probably about the time my arm got cut off.
Does anything make it better or worse?
Not having an arm makes it pretty bad.
What about any family members? Do they exhibit any symptoms like this?
Nah, they all got limbs.
Have you been in contact with any animals or any type of insect bites? Anything like that?
No! I have not!
Are you exhibiting a Raynaud sign?
What is a Raynaud sign?
I don't know. What about significant life events?
Having my arm chopped off is pretty significant!
Hey, slow down there, Chip Bean!
What are you even doing?
I'm gonna find a patient with their own behavior!
Hey, Jimbo! Alright, we're gonna run 73 tests on you. That'll be $180,000. There you go.
Hey man, I've got a patient up in room 3. I need to get some blood cultures and CSF cultures and a Holter monitor put on them. Do you think you could take care of that for me?
Yeah man, no problem.
Ding!
There you go.
Wow, that was incredibly fast. Thank you.
We like to be efficient out here.
Alright, now hold still.
Whoa. What are you doing?
I'm testing his corneal reflex.
Seriously, Melvin? Just give it to me.
Alright, Mr. Johnson, moving on to the physical exam. Take your pants off.
Whoa!
Hey, yo, I'm having some trouble getting this guy's temperature.
Yeah, what's up?
Yeah, let's not let me do it.
Bro, that's a speculum.
Oh. yeah, sorry about that, wrong button. Yeah, it's kind of awkward. Well, there might be an issue if I was a real doctor.
Wait, what?
Huh?
Alright, I'm ready to turn this thing in. What do y'all think the diagnosis is?
Well, if you got pancytopenia with secondary metabolic anemia, you're absolutely right. But there's no way you knew that. You Googled it.
Who are you and why are you in my house?